presence here. Hallelujah. If you go to the hospitals of this world, the doctors are going to attend to you only, and they will work on your problems. You, the presenting person. But in this hospital, it doesn't work that way. God works in his own way. No, the doctor will fix your situation and fix the situation in your family, with your families, family members not being here. You are seated here and he will be fixing your situation at your workplace. You seated here. You will be working in a number of areas. I love this God. He is an amazing God, a miracle working God, a powerful God who cannot be restricted by anything. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise Jesus. Can I see the hands of those who love him? Do you love him with all your heart? Do you appreciate him in your life? Do you believe that he is at work right now in your life? Hey, you sit there, you relax, he is at work. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And your whole life, as you are sitting there, is before him. Your whole life. Amen. And he cares about your spiritual existence. Your spiritual life. He cares about your physical life. He cares about everything that you have. And seated there today, he is working every area, spiritually, physically, materially. He's working. As you are seated there, even that bank account of yours is before you. And he is the Lord who feels pity on for you. He has got pity on you. He has got compassion. His compassions never fail. They are fresh every morning. So he's looking at somebody even now, and he sees that bank account that has got nothing. And he is going like, shame. You have to do something. Angels are being sent to go change your situation as you are sitting there. When you have entered here, hey, tell your neighbor, I'm admitted today. Yeah? I'm a patient in the hospital of God. I'm admitted, and I'm hopeful that my situation will change. I'm so hopeful. Amen. You know, when you have come here, when you are admitted into this hospital, when we're busy admitting you, we don't admit you to tell you about ourselves. We tell you about the great doctor, and we tell you that he is able, you know. Don't worry about your situation. You have come to the right hospital. He's going to fix it perfectly so. Things are going to change. You're not going to die. Hey, you're not going to continue suffering. You know, when you have come here, your suffering has come to an end. Our job is to tell you that it shall be well. This Dr. Jesus, he has never failed. Not even in one case. Not a single one. So he's not going to fail today with your case. He has solved all of them that he intervened in. And today, when you present yours before him, he's not going to start failing today. He's going to deal with it. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Peter said, hey, Aeneas, Jesus, the Christ, heals you. Stand up. Take up your mat. Make your bed. Walk. Jesus, the Christ. Are you hearing that? Are you hearing that? You are seated here. I'm not going to tell you that Pastor Mukuba is healing you. I'll be lying. Jesus, the Christ, is healing you. Jesus, the Christ, is working in your life. Hallelujah. Is somebody looking forward to seeing changes? Are you looking forward to seeing changes? And you know, in this hospital, there is no payment that you can really take out and then is enough. Do you know what payment is requested? There is payment, of course, that is needed. It's just that it's not monetary. There is payment that is needed. The payment that you have to make is faith. That's it. Can somebody say faith? Faith. That is what is needed. That is what is needed. You just need to have faith. And then healing takes place. The healing of your life, the restoration of your life, the promotion of your life. And I know that somebody is getting promoted as we sit here. Somebody is getting taken to another level in life. Somebody is getting healed. Somebody is getting restored as you are seated here in the mighty name of Jesus. And the things will not remain the same. Hallelujah. Can you clap to the Lord? And can somebody go, Lord, heal my life. Lord, restore my life. Work in my life. Lord, I believe in you. I believe in your word. Lord, help me overcome my unbelief. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise Jesus. Amen. Amen. Do you believe in the Lord? Do you believe that he is the healer of all areas of your life and all your sufferings, all your diseases? Are there people who are in pain right now? Don't come if the pain is not there now. I don't want you to go back with other people's pains. Your healer. I'm only calling people who are in pain now. I said my word.
Abantu abanenhlungu ngoku.
Your disease. I am the Lord. Your healer, I am the Lord, that healeth thee. I am the Lord, your healer. I said my word and heal your disease. I am the Lord, your healer. You are the Lord,
You are the Lord, my healer. You send your word, and heal my disease. You are the Lord. It is the will of the Lord to heal you. That pain has to go now. That pain has to stop. And yes, the healing anointing is flowing all over this place. The healing Jesus. am the Lord. Now. Now.
And get healed to receive their deliverance here. Because when you are taking them back there, there is nothing back there. Delivered, be free, be free, be free, be free, be free, be free, be free. I said my word. Just bring me that lady with the white dress. Yes. Yes. Touch, oh Lord. In Jesus' name.
I'm now today.
Your grace, all anxiety, your spirit of anxiety, get out, get out. I command the spirit of depression. Bring her here.
Now! Now! Out! Out! Come out!
Just raise up your hands and talk to the Lord about your life, about your situation.
Tapelo tsa rona di tla nyolohela.
It means our prayers shall go up and be before the Father.
Morena utsiva matata aruna.
God knows your problem. He knows what is bothering you. And as I said, you are in the hospital of the Lord, and the Lord heals your life. Talk to him. Yes, Lord. Heal their lives. Heal their situations. Heal their conditions. In the mighty name of Jesus. Take care of them, Father. In Jesus' name. Take care of their lives. In the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, intervene. Intervene, Father Lord. In Jesus' name. Yes, touch them, Lord. Touch them one by one. Touch them, Father Lord. And change their situations, mighty one. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Lord, we thank you. You can clap to the Lord.
There is power, wonder-working power in the precious blood of the Lamb. There is power, wonder-working power in the precious blood of the Lamb. There is power.
There is power.
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 Wonder-working power in the precious blood.
Just
blood. There is power.
There
Hallelujah. Amen. Can somebody go? There is power in the blood of Jesus. There is power in the blood of the Lamb. Hallelujah. And today, by the way, we are going to have Holy Communion. A reminder of the power of the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. Let me quickly go through this teaching, and then we are going to have a Holy Communion. Can somebody go to 1 Corinthians chapter 4?
There is power in the blood of Jesus. There is power in the blood of Jesus. There is power in the blood of Jesus. Here it was, Jesus, whiter than the snow.
Hallelujah. Have you found 1 Corinthians chapter 4? Verse 15 says, for though you might have 10,000 instructors in Christ, yet you do not have many fathers. For in Christ Jesus, I have begotten you through the gospel. Therefore, I urge you, imitate me. For this reason, I have sent Timothy to you, who is my beloved and faithful son in the Lord, who will remind you of my ways in Christ, as I teach everywhere in every church. Hallelujah. Can you bow your head? Lord God, we thank you for the reading of your word. Mighty God, we honor you. Speak to us. We are listening. Spirit of the living God, minister to our hearts. Yes, Father, we thank you. We glorify you. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Praise Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Can we talk about something to do with sonship? Paul was talking to the church of the Corinthians. The church of the Corinthians. He wrote to them, teaching them, admonishing them, rebuking them, encouraging them. And he said that he was not writing what he was writing to shame them, but as beloved children, he needed to warn them. He started a church in Corinth, and he wanted that church to continue doing as he taught them, standing for what he as a father stands for, continuing in the ways that he has taught them, not listening to things that will not help them. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Paul saw that it was like there was confusion And he wrote.
Wabhala.
And he said,
Wathi,
though you may have 10,000 instructors in Christ, though you may have many teachers, though you may be receiving quite a lot of teaching from different places, maybe you read books, maybe you watch the gospel channels, maybe you read messages written on WhatsApp and on
Facebook.
He said, though you may have those instructors, you do not have many fathers. You have got one father. Many instructors, but one father.
Somebody getting
that?
He
said, for in Christ Jesus, I have begotten you through the gospel. In Christ Jesus, I gave birth to you through the gospel. Somebody getting that? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
My bongwe
Nkosi. And he, as a father, said to the church, imitate me. Imitate me. I am your father. Imitate me. Do as I do. Walk like me. Talk like me. Do as I do. Imitate me as I imitate
Christ.
Imitate me as I imitate Christ. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Are you getting that? Are you getting that? I stand here before you. Before the church of Christ, before this family of unity. And I want to say that, child of God, you may have many instructors, but when you are here at unity, born again here, you have got one father, the one who preached the gospel to you, the one who is preaching the gospel to you, who has begotten you in Christ Jesus. Paul started this church and he did not want them to deviate from what he stands for, from the true gospel. And when he goes on, he says, for this reason, I've sent Timothy to you. And Timothy is my beloved and faithful son in the Lord, who will remind you of my ways in Christ as I teach everywhere in every church. And let me say to you,
unity,
I have begotten you through the gospel in Christ Jesus. Are we getting that? I have given birth to you through the gospel in Christ Jesus. I am a father to you, and you are my sons in Christ Jesus. Are you hearing that? Are you understanding that? And because I don't want you to get lost, because I don't want you to forget what we are doing and what we stand for. Because I don't want you to forget that. I want you to be reminded of my ways. For I want you to imitate me as I'm imitating Christ. Hallelujah.
Amen.
For those reasons, like Paul, I say, I've sent my Timothy to you.
my beloved son, my faithful son, I've sent him to you to remind you of my ways. You are not supposed to forget what we stand for. You are not supposed to be confused by different instructors, different teachings that you receive, that you get. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
My bongwing goes.
Yes, I go around preaching everywhere in the churches of Christ. You here in Cape Town, I've sent you my beloved faithful son Timothy. That is my
Timothy.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
My bong queen.
Praise Jesus.
Magabongu, yes.
Paul was able to talk about his son, Timothy, his spiritual son, as a beloved son, as a true son. Hallelujah.
Amen.
As a what? A true son. Amen.
Amen.
Just go to First Timothy chapter 1, just for a while. First Timothy chapter 1. Oh, there you go. Listen to how this letter is written to Timothy by the Father. In verse 2 there. To Timothy, a true son in faith. To Timothy, a what? A true son in faith. Grace, mercy, and peace from God our Father and Jesus Christ our Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
To Timothy. Timothy, who is a true son in faith. A son who is trusted with the precious things. A son who can be sent out and represent the Father very well. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When Pastor Nkuna is here, Pastor Nkuna represent me. He represents me. He teaches what I've sent him to come and teach you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And when I stand,
can't you see, ma?
I represent Christ. I don't represent myself. I represent Christ. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
My goes.
When you listen to Pastor Nkuna, it means you listen to me. And which means that you listen to Christ. You obey him, it means you obey me, and it means you obey Christ. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. He's not here to talk about himself. I'm not here to talk about myself. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
My bong,
I say to the church, once you start seeing me walking sideways, no longer preaching the true gospel, representing myself, and preaching my own things, and living anyhow, run for your life. Because your loyalty, the ultimate one, lies with the ultimate authority. If he becomes unfaithful, you hear that? If you become unfaithful, these ones are supposed to be loyal to the higher authority above you. They have to be loyal to me. They cannot listen to you against what I instruct. If I become disloyal to
Christ,
you are not supposed to listen to me. Your loyalty lies with Christ. Do you hear the order of things? When I've sent him here, if he comes and then he starts teaching his own things that I didn't send him to teach,
you have to go tring tring, pastor. This person this side is doing his own things. I will say, Fundis, sit down.
If I started teaching my own things, the Lord Jesus will remove me. You go to the Lord and say, this person whom you have set above us has started doing her own things. Our ultimate loyalty lies with Christ.
No Christ.
You understand? You understand that? Hallelujah.
Amen.
True sons.
True
sons are what God is looking for in the church. Those who are loyal. Not butterflies. Who do not stay in one place. With many colors. People who are not stable. Whom you cannot depend on. Do you know? There are sons. Who are the opposite. Of what a father would want. Of course. Paul. Was happy to have Timothy. To have Timothy as a spiritual son. Like Elijah was happy to have an Elisha. Moses. Joshua. Amen.
Amen.
Sons whom you can trust. Just get a chair and sit down. To listen and have your notebooks, you need to be writing this down. When I'm teaching, you don't stand up, you sit down and you write down what I'm teaching. Sons who can be trusted with the gospel, because the gospel is valuable. So you need sons like Timothy whom you can send out when you are busy with your work of apostleship. Then you can place Timothy there, another Timothy there, another Timothy there, and then they represent what you stand for. Hallelujah.
Amen.
They teach the people to imitate you as you imitate Christ. There are those who say, we cannot hear from the pastor, we hear from God. How can you hear from God whom you cannot see if you cannot hear from the pastor whom you see every day? That is what is said about love. How can you say you love God if you cannot love your brother whom you can see every day? And remember, your pastor, your spiritual father, stands in the place of Christ in your life. Yeah. That is why, when you are deep into trouble, when you are deep into trouble, when you are troubled, and when you are under attack, Jesus will appear to you, even in your dreams. Not in his own form that you don't know. But he will appear in the form of your pastor whom you know. And then you're going to say, pastor, I saw you in my my dreams, what this and that was happening. It's not your pastor, it's God appearing in the form that you understand. God visiting you in the form of what is familiar to you, in the form of what you know, and that should show you that in your pastor, God has placed somebody in his own place in your life. Amen.
Amen.
Are you getting that? When you listen and obey, you listen and obey God. When you obey your pastor. When you reject the one who's put in authority in your life, you reject God himself. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. True sons. True sons. Oh Joshua.
Oh Joshua.
When everybody is going. What is wrong with that car? How long will they keep on pushing it during a service? Didn't they come to attend the service? Joshua,
oh, Joshua,
who are going to be sent out by Moses.
Moses.
And when everybody comes back with a negative message, and they are going, what you have sent us to do, we have done it, but it is impossible for us to achieve any victory that you are believing in.
It
is impossible for us to do what you want us to do. And then the true sons who stand with their fathers will go. We can conquer the enemies. They are bred to us. Let us go and attack. When everybody else is doubting the word from the servant of God, the true sons will say, we are with you. We are moving with you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Praise Jesus. You know, there are some sons and some servants that you would not want to have. When you read Genesis chapter
4,
we hear about Cain and Abel, sons of
Adam.
Who would want to have a king as a son of his? Not me. Not me. A son who will not do what is right. And then he becomes a murderer. In the church, we have got those kinds of sons. They don't want to do what is right. And they are full of hatred towards the brothers who are doing what is right. They refuse. They refuse to do the right things. And when others are doing the right things and are favored, then they complain. They say he thinks he's better. Then they start competition inside the church. In church, we don't compete. We work together as a team. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are not in competition.
Asiko
kukupiswa. There are people in church. They bring about division. Because they are competing. They want to be seen as the best in the eyes of the pastor. And the people gauge their importance based on what they do at church. Standing there and ushering the pastor does not make you the best person in the church. Standing here and leading worship does not make you the best person in the church. Not in the things of God, it doesn't work that way. Positions that people glorify are not glorified than others in the eyes of God. Before the eyes of the Lord, the hand is important, the stomach is important, the ear is important, so are the legs that are down there.
Hey.
So the head should not say, I'm important than you leg, because you are down there. If we cut the leg, the hand will become dysfunctional. The hand will be limited. People dignify different positions. They're in competition. Let me tell you, what you are looking at and you say that is very important, I wish I was there. I wish I was interpreting the pastor. In the eyes of God, somebody here who is a quiet intercessor, nobody has ever taken notice of that person. But that person prays every day at home. That person intercedes for the pastor without even telling the pastor. And nobody knows him. And he is doing a great, great job. But he is not in the eyes of people. Our ways are not the same as God's ways. Our standards. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
In whatever that you are assigned to do, be a trooper. If they say your job is to scrub the toilets, scrub them to the best of your ability. If they say your job is to sweep the yard, sweep it to the best of your ability. And be full of dust. Don't say because I sweep the yard, then I'm of a lower rank than the one who's standing at the pulpit. You are thinking that is a worldly mentality.
Amen.
Competition leads to hatred. Because as you are busy competing, you wish your brother can fall so that you can be number one. You are busy practicing witchcraft. In your heart, you are a witch. You are a murderer. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
My bongo.
Praise Jesus.
Magabongo, yes.
Are we getting that?
Ingaba,
are we getting that?
Siyakufumana noko.
If you practice competition,
ukuba wenza ukhuphiswano,
the people who do that don't even want to do what is right before the eyes of God.
Abafuni kwenza okulungileyo emehlweni
kaThixo. They wake God, let the pastor see me.
Basebenza nzima ukuba umfundisi ababone.
They don't care what God sees.
Abakhathali ukuba
uThixo
ubona
nto. God sees them that their hearts are not right.
UThixo abone ukuba inhliziyo zabo azilunganga.
God said, okay, if you do what is right, won't you be accepted? Concentrate on doing what is right. Be a son who does what is right. Running your race. Sticking to your own track.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Are you getting that? So I wouldn't want to have the canes
and not funny Jengonyan.
And when we read Genesis 9,
asifunda ku Genesis 9,
about the sons of Noah,
ngonyana baka Noah,
I don't want to have him.
Andina kufuna bana
him. Canaan is a son.
Canaan jengonyan.
No.
Ay.
A son.
Unyan.
Who will see my nakedness?
Oya utaupo nukuzi.
And expose it.
Akita kuchivezi.
And say, hey, come see.
Izani nizobo.
My father is drunk.
Uba owa mungali.
And exposed.
Atakile.
I don't want such a son.
Andina ufunu nyanu cha.
Who exposes the nakedness.
Otavezo buzebo mzahana.
Of his father.
Uba owa ke.
People who are in the church.
Abantu basebandleni.
And they are busy looking for mistakes in the pastor.
Bachonge mpazamo kumfundisi.
Then they go out.
Bayenga pan.
And they talk about it.
Batetengas.
Do you know the wife?
Bachiamazungu.
Do you know the husband?
Uyamazunye.
Do you know the sons?
Uyamazunye.
Do you know the daughters?
Uyamazunye.
They are like this. They're yep. Canaan was cursed. Because of that. Their two brothers, when they were told, they said, we cannot even look. We cannot even look. Let's take something and move backwards without looking. Without looking at it. And cover. Some people make it their job, their responsibility, to expose the nakedness of figures of authority. They specialize in that. The Aarons and the Miriams, they go like, oh, the wife,
the
Cushite. Cushite woman.
But in God's cush.
Hey, he married an Ethiopian woman.
But how chatum fazos.
He married a woman like this.
But chatum goes kazanji.
And then they criticize.
But like.
They criticize the spouse.
But like on goes kaz.
Of their own pastor.
On fundis wabo.
They look for faults.
But kangel is post.
In his children.
Ebantuan
and they go around talking about that.
But kube geba tetengo.
Mm-hmm. But they continue to come to church. And the Lord will say, you have seen me working through my servant. You have seen me talking to my servant. Were you not afraid to talk badly about somebody that I talk to face to face? Are you not afraid to criticize somebody who stands before me and we talk face to face? There are people in the church who have got leprosy today, like
Miriam.
Maybe you don't have a physical leprosy, but you've got leprosy, you've got a disease that is eating away your life beat by beat. Beat by beat is eating away.
Leprosy.
In your life. Because of what comes from your mouth. Talk to your neighbor there and say, watch your mouth. Watch your mouth. Watch your mouth. Watch what you say. Because you can have leprosy. Because of talking things that you are not supposed to talk about. Did you hear him?
He said that.
And what I've seen. What I've seen at Unity. When a person starts grumbling inside, when they start having a critical spirit, when they start having their own things that are against the servant of God, God removes them out of the gate. You know, I've seen that some of them are removed from my side before I even know what they are doing. I find out later. God just cleans, he doesn't want any debt to linger around his servants. Because they are his servants. Amen.
Amen.
You need to understand something. When we are together like this, I'm not your biological mother. I'm not your aunt. I'm not your elder sister or your younger sister. I might look like them physically. I might be of their age, but I'm not. When we are here, we have been brought together in this one kind of relationship that I know. God setting me as a spiritual parent to you. I don't know of any other relationship except that one. Here, I've set somebody, Pastor Nkuna, to come in a position of authority. No other relationship that you are going to have with him except that. If you can start saying your own things as if we are cousins, you get yourself in trouble. So if you are used to talking to your mother anyhow, to your father anyhow at home, to your aunt anyhow at all, don't even think of practicing it here. Because the person who's over you represents God in your life. You become disrespectful, you disrespect God, you get into trouble with God. That is why God himself cleans his church all the time. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because there is this relationship that he has set, the way of relating that he has put into place. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Who would want to have sons like the brothers of Joseph?
Brothers of Joseph.
They see
Babon.
Joseph.
Uyosef.
Is loved by the father. Joseph.
Uyosef.
Has got something special. Put in by God. And then they go.
Bye.
We hate him.
But yes, I'm okay.
We hate him. Somebody who is chosen in the family to save their lives, they say we hate him. And then they go, let us kill him. They don't even care how the father will feel. They don't care. They are in competition. Oh, our father loves him. Let's get rid of him. Maybe their father will love us more when he is gone. And you know the painful part is that Joseph was sold when he was sent to look after the brothers to bring them food. Here is somebody in the church, a brother of yours in the church, who works more than everybody else, who's helpful to the father in the ministry. This son, whom the father sends to you to take care of you, to bring you food, and then you say, ah, let us kill him. Let us kill him. Dip this multicolored rope in blood. They did that. Dipped it. He took it, dipped it. Took it to the father. Said, is this not your son? Is this not your son's? And they set the father's heart into grieving. There are sons like that in the church who work against everybody who's helpful to them.
Pastor.
They don't want anybody who is helping. They fight that person. They want to mess the anointing in that person. They want to kill him. To do away with him. And if he can fall, they rejoice. They are happy. I don't want sons like the brothers of Joseph who are full of jealousy, full of envy. And God does not approve of that anyway. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Brothers who compete with somebody's calling, somebody's anointing. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
My
you know, with Pastor Nkuna here, you might find somebody going like, is he the only one who can do the job? I can also do it. Anyway, I speak English better than him. Did you hear him? How he called that? That was wrong. That is not proper English.
Ayo English elungileyo ke leya.
And they go. I understand the Bible better than him. You see that message that was preaching? I can unpack it in a beautiful way. After you have listened to T.D. Jakes' preaching it on TV. And you are interpreting the pastor. Be an interpreter. And be satisfied with it.
Amen.
I've worked with interpreters who would be interpreting me, and at the same time when they get home they are busy imitating my voice, and when they have imitated it enough then they say we can also do it.
But I not to sing queens.
Once you develop that in your heart, you are gone. Before I even know it, you are gone. That devil said, oh, if God was just afraid, God is just jealous, he's afraid that if you eat that, you will be like him. Why would I want to be God? And then Eve was tempted by that. The devil said,
how?
Can it just be God receiving the praises? I'm also beautiful. I can sing very well. I can play the piano very well. Why is the praise not coming to me? Why is the worship not coming to me? Same way the devil was thrown out of heaven, dark, big, like lightning. It's the same way you are going to fall if you start having that in your heart. And you are going to find yourself outside and you will be like,
hey,
how did I land here? You were thrown down. You were thrown down. And there are those, when they see that you have got meat, they come. My brother. My sister, you are so beautiful. So beautiful. You are so beautiful. There is no one who sings like you. No one who speaks like you. No one who prays like you. Hey.
Hey.
Ah,
kwenta kwetu.
You see?
Yabona.
The pastor should just give you the pulpit.
Umfundisi funeka nje akunike
pulpit. And see what God has placed there inside you.
Abona ukuba indono uThixo ibekile yapho kuwe.
And then we see you when you come to the pulpit.
Sikubona xa usize pulpit.
Now, when you want to sing, we hear even the voice is changed. There is no more flow of the anointing because now you are full of yourself. I heard this guy who used to lead worship at church. Then I was surprised. The worship team will practice songs.
Worship team,
and on Sunday when he stands up, he will start singing other songs and what is going on now? And then there was no flow of anointing. No flow of anointing. I know the people that I work with. I'll be thinking or I'll be singing a song in the morning. I'll get to church, I'll find them singing it. What is going on? Why are these songs now? Only to find out that there are some sisters in the church. They say, ah, hey, my brother, when you sing that song, hey. Then he kills the whole church because of his own ego. Being told you are so beautiful. In
Venezuela,
we say, anongo na kazone.
You are so beautiful.
There is the vulture having meat. And there is the jackal.
Ibelapho.
Wanting the meat.
Ifuninya.
Say, hey, you look beautiful. And you know you can sing.
Everyone.
You sing beautiful, more beautiful than everyone else. Can you sing that one, that one, that one? And then, that one, the bird forgets that he has got meat. And then he begins,
wah!
And the meat goes, and when the meat goes, the jackal takes the meat.
And
then the meat goes,
go.
And who are you going to sing to? No one.
Amen. Amen.
Sons like Absalom.
Oh, nyana bafana no Absalom.
No, no, no,
ay, 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 ay.
No, 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 no.
Ay, 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 ay.
Sons like Absalom.
Oh, nyana bafana no
who wanted the seat
abafuni
of the father?
Sikaba.
Even the wives.
Namakoskans.
Hey, what? Absalom.
Oh, Absalom.
He said to the people,
watikubant.
Where do you come from?
Nifilapi.
What is your case? They tell him their case. And after that he says, if only I was a judge over your case.
No,
my brother, you have got a case. You were going to win this case. If only I was the judge. Not him, not my father. I was going to help you. There are people like that in the church. They try to look better than the pastor in the eyes of other brothers. When the pastor says, hey, what are you doing? After church, they take that brother by hand.
Don't worry.
Don't worry.
Don't worry.
They want everyone to now look upon them as the savior of the people. The pastor is bad. They are the good ones. If they are in
counseling,
you send them to go say something to somebody. Like what my husband would say at church. There are those things that he would send you that are so difficult that he would send you to go tell somebody. He would say like, go ask that one if he is mad. Or go ask that one if he is a witch. Or is he practicing witchcraft here at church? And if you are an Absalom, You're not going to be able to carry out that instruction.
Amen.
Ah, you're not going to do it.
Amen.
Go and deliver that message. When you come back, when we ask you, what did you say? You will say, I said, he should not do things that way. That is not what we sent you to go and say.
Amen.
But you want to appear as a better person to the people. Somebody gets rebuked. You are the one who follows them. You don't follow them to say, you know what, my brother, what you did is wrong, and the father is rebuking you because he wants things to go well with you. You go there, you say, hey, what can we do? We just have to be patient and persevere. As if you are wrong. And what happened to the sympathizers? When Moses' opposers were killed by God, when the earth opened and swallowed them, those who sympathized and said, Moses, you killed the people of God, what happened to them? They died in a plague. Sympathizers are going to suffer the same wrath as the offenders. You sympathize with somebody who's sinning against the church of God. Then you become a partaker in that person's sin. And both of you shall suffer the wrath of God.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Praise Jesus. For Absalom.
Absalom.
They are self-appointed counselors in the church. They don't send people with problems to the pastor. When they are dealing with the issues, they are not going to report what is going on to the pastor. They are people's comforters, self-appointed. Absalom will die.
Absalom will die.
Absalom will die. David will remain the king. Because
David
is appointed by God. People who direct attention to themselves, they are in trouble. Okay. Are you getting that? Who wants to work with Jehaz? Oh, not me.
I am not.
Somebody with an independent mind who goes against the instructions that you give. Elisha says, Naaman, I don't want your pay for the healing. Jehoshaphat says, my master is wrong. I'm going to go and make this wrong. Settle his donkey, goes after Naaman. And then he says, Naaman, my master has changed his mind.
There
is a man who arrived. He needs silver, gold, he needs articles of clothing. Independent mind. Such a son will not receive the impartation of the master. Such a servant will not move in the same anointing as the master. That is why when Jehaz was told, go with the staff, raise the dead son of the Shunammite woman. Nothing happened because there was no flow of anointing. God takes from the spirit of the father and he places that in the sons. Impartation.
Amen.
So if you are not moving with your father in your heart, you will not receive any anointing. You won't be able to do as the father does. But Elisha was able to do what Elijah did, and even more than that, because he moved with Elijah in obedience. He refused Even in the last day, when he was getting released, he was with him till the end. That is why he could move in the same anointing, double portion.
Amen.
Amen. Who would want to work with Judas
Iscariot?
Somebody who will steal from you. Somebody who steals from you is killing you. It's killing you. And somebody who will sell you. They go out. They say, are you looking to destroy him? To destroy him? Are you looking to destroy them? I know how you can do it. Because I'm working closely. Hey, I'm close. I can tell you how to get to this person. I can tell you how to get to the pastor. I can tell you the weak point. I can tell you where you can find the pastor. The Judas Iscariot. Who would want those as sons? Who would want those as disciples? Who would want those as servants? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. May the Lord release the Timothys into the houses of God. The Timothys who can be trusted, who can be relied on. When you send them out, you don't have to worry about anything. You know that they are not going to be doing their own things. You know that they are going to represent you well. You know that they are going to teach the people your way. You know that when even when they go out of church, you do not worry that when they go to the office, they will misrepresent your name. You do not worry that when they go to school, they will paint the ministry bed. But sons who cannot be trusted will go out, and through the way they live, they will give the church a bad name. Through what they do, wherever they are, they give the pastor a bad name. We want Timothys who are going to go back at home. They look at you, they see God. At work, they look at you, they see God. At school, they look at you, they see God. Such sons are the ones that we want here at Unity. Can somebody clap to God? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Have you heard the word? If there is a need to repent in your heart, bow your head and speak to the Lord right now. Thank him for the word that you have heard. Thank him for the word that you have heard. Because this is the word that is supposed to stay inside you. And if repentance is needed there, speak to him and say, Father, Father, I have sinned before you. Today, I've heard your word, and I repent of my sins. Lord Jesus, I'm ready to leave my old ways and follow you in truth. I want to be a true worshiper. Lord Jesus, restore my life. Restore my life. In Jesus' name, Father Lord, I thank you for forgiving me and for cleansing me of all unrighteousness. In Jesus' name, you can clap to Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Now we move, we are going to have Holy Communion together. Powerful, powerful way of fellowship. On the night that the Lord was betrayed, he had the last meal with the disciples in the upper room. And he said to them, continue to do this in remembrance of me. And we do that as it is instituted by him, the Holy Communion. The Holy Communion, very powerful, symbolizing something very powerful. It's a physical act that symbolizes something spiritual, something that is very powerful. When we have a Holy Communion, we proclaim the death of Christ, and we shall proclaim it till he comes. We proclaim the victories that were won at the cross. We say, yes, we know it happened. And as a result of what happened at Calvary, we are saved. We are new creations. We are made victorious over sin, over all the things of the enemy. And we are thankful in our hearts. We are grateful to the Lord who did what he did more than 2,000 years ago, dying for us on the cross. You can come, Pastor Mangun. Where is he? We thank you for your body. Your body that was given for our lives. That was bruised for our healing. Yes, the body that opened the way for us to can be able to approach the most holy place. Thank you for this bread that symbolizes your body, Lord. And yes, he who has the bread, Jesus, shall not hunger again. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. You may have the bread. Yes, Lord. Yes, Jesus. Yes, mighty God. Thank you for this cup, Lord. We thank you for the blood of the new covenant, the covenant that covers us, that provides for us. The covenant in the blood of Jesus. Lord, we appreciate our salvation, our deliverance. Yes, Lord Jesus, thank you for suffering for us. Your blood was shed so that we could receive life. And today here, we receive all the benefits of the cross in Jesus' name. Start with all the workers. Just move forward and have Holy Communion. You can have Holy Communion. Yes, Lord, of Ashanda, of Asit. Kurian. Menderia Ravasika Lorobo Shandaravahu Yeriandarava City Rebellion Deria Ravahu Yeriandarava City Rebellion Uravava. The first rose, you can move forward and have Holy Communion. Every blessing, every salvation, every healing, every deliverance, every breakthrough sealed with the blood of Jesus. Yes, the seal over everything that you have received, and there is no one who can be able to take that away from you. In the mighty name of Jesus, as you come forward, allow yourself to receive all the blessings coming from the cross of Jesus, the restoration, the revival, yes, the energizing, the revitalizing, yes, Father Lord, in the name of Jesus, the healing, in the mighty name of Jesus, yes, the watering, in Jesus' name,
Kirevele yenderi arabaha. Rovo rondorio rovo sikarabala yandari arabaho. Rovo rondorio rovo shekerebele yende. Riva va 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 va. Kuri andaraba sete. Lorovo rondorio rovo ho. Manderia kabala yandari araba sete rebele yanda. Riva va 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 andari araba kayate. Loro riondorovo sherebele yandaraba kayate. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for your goodness, Lord, flowing from the cross of the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, mighty one. Balaraba shekerebele yende. Rova rondorio rovo serereria kabalayando. Rova rondoria raba shatarabalayandariara. Reverenderia raba kaya. More of your blessings upon them, Father. Upon them, Lord, all of them, Lord, bless them, bless their families, Lord. Bless them, Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, your goodness, Lord, upon them. Your glory covering them, Father, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Bolarabasata rabala yandariaro. Robarondori arabasete rebele yandariara. Oriandario rabakayat rabalaha. Roborondo riorobo sherere di andarabasiki. Lariandaria rebesere di andarabacayatari arabalayandu. Roborondo riara bacayatari arabalayan. Reverendaria rebeha. Loroborondo riorobo coyatarabalaha. Yes, Laura. Yes, Jesus, every curse getting broken. Yes, every curse getting broken, Lord. As your people have this communion this afternoon, Lord. Every curse getting broken, every curse in their lives, every curse in their families, Lord. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Yes, let the blessings follow them, Lord. Let the goodness follow them. Blessed they are going in and they are coming out, mighty God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Father Lord. Yes, Jesus. Your mercy, your grace, O Lord, upon their lives, Lord. Your mercy, Father Lord. Your grace, O Lord. In Jesus' name, Lord God, take care of their situations, Father. Of their conditions, mighty God, in the mighty name of Jesus, every chain getting broken right now, every bondage getting loose right now, in the name of Jesus. Can you move that side? In Jesus' name, in the mighty name of Jesus, can we come this side quickly so that we can finish? In the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Father Lord, the floodgates of heaven opened for them, Lord. The floodgates of heaven, releasing the blessings, the rain, Lord, the floods, yes, of blessings upon your people, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord God, we thank you for giving them breakthroughs in Jesus' name, for giving them breakthroughs, Lord, for answering their prayers, mighty God, in the mighty name of Jesus, in Jesus' name. Yes, O Lord, Abashandori, O Robosete, Rebellion, Dariara. Yes, Father Lord, your eyes upon these children, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus, they belong to you, Father. They belong to you, mighty God. And yes, we commit their lives into your hands, their existence into your hands, Father Lord. Yes, dedicating their lives into your hands, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. Bless them, Lord. Bless them, Father. Bless them, mighty God. Bless them, Jehovah. Bless them, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. 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 Yes, Lord. You're covering, my God. You're covering over them, Lord. Cover them, oh Father, Lord. Cover their lives, oh Lord. Yes, devil, you are rebuked in their lives. You are not allowed to work against their lives. You are not allowed to anywhere near them. Lord, cover them with the blood of Jesus. Cover them with your fire. With your fire, Lord. With your fire. With your fire. Yes, Lord, Abashandorioro. Let them grow up, oh Lord, to be great men and women who bring glory to your Father. Let them grow up walking in your light, oh Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus, let them grow in wisdom, oh Father. In wisdom, oh mighty God. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, Lord, we thank you. Lord, we thank you. We thank you for these young ones, Lord. We thank you for these children, mighty God. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, let your angels guard them day and night, mighty God. Let your angels look after them even when they're at school, oh Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus, and prosper them even in their studies, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus, they are your creation, your artwork, your handiwork created to do good. Lord God, let your plans about them come to pass, oh Lord. Let your plans about their lives come to pass, oh Father, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus, in Jesus' name, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you. You can clap to the Lord. Just clap to the Lord. Just clap to Jesus. Clap to Jesus. Clap to Jesus. Clap to Jesus. Just give him the glory. Give him the glory. Give him the glory. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Can I see all the mothers standing up? All the mothers, everyone who is a mother. You can be a mother because you are a married woman. You can be a mother because you have got a child. It is Mother's Day today. And I just want to tell you that God loves you very much. God cares about you. You are chosen by God to play very important roles in the lives of others. As a mother, you are chosen to nurture others, to care for others. Very, very important. What can we be without mothers? What can we be? Can we really exist? We get born through them. And we know this earth now. It is because of them. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise Jesus. And mothers go through quite a lot. You look after other people, but still you are faced with many challenges. Sometimes even those you look after, they don't even appreciate, but you continue to look after them. Sometimes those that you are taking care of, they cause you grief, but you continue to love them because as a mother, you are given that kind of love which is very special. And I want to say, don't be discouraged no matter what happens in your life. God is with you. And God knows the role that he has assigned for your life. And he is never going to leave you nor forsake you. And just raise up your hands, all the mothers there. Yes, Father Lord. Look at them, my God. Occupy the office which you have set for them. Bless them, Father. All of them. Bless them. Bless their lives in Jesus' name. Bless their existence in Jesus' name. Lord God, bless their children. Bless their families. In the mighty name of Jesus, give Give them strength, Lord. Comfort them. In the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name. Even those who are single mothers, Lord. Be there for them. And be their helper. Even those who are widowed. Yes, Father. You are a father to their children. For you are the father to the fatherless. Lord God, your special blessing on this day, in the mighty name of Jesus, you just open your heart there and receive the goodness of the Lord over your life. The goodness of the Lord over you right now. Just receive. Just receive, just receive, just receive, just receive there in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, breakthroughs are yours, victories are yours. The Lord is answering your prayers. What you have been crying about has come before the face of God. Yes, Lord, let it be. Let it be, mighty one. And Lord, protect them from all attacks. Protect them from the attacks of the evil one. Protect their families. Protect their children. In Jesus' name. And Father, Lord, deliver them from the hands of the enemy. In the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. And the Lord, heal them of all their pains, all the diseases. Heal them, Father. Heal their hearts that are broken, that are bruised. Because of the challenges that they face, your healing, Lord, your healing, Jesus. We thank you, Father. We bless your name. Amen. Hallelujah. Just clap to Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. And can I hear those who are seated down saying to those mothers, we appreciate you. You can stand up and shake their hands. Tell them that you love them, you appreciate them. Tell them that. And can I see the Unity Cape Town children coming forward to dance for their mothers?
Jonana, Jonana, Yonana, yo ho. Jonana, Jonana, Yonana, yo ho. Jonana, Jonana, Yonana. Jonana. Hey!
see the fathers coming to dance. Okay, we slow it a bit, man, for the fathers. All the fathers, you dance for the mothers.
Uku kanzu kasi Jesu. Oh, inkandale yo. Uku kanzu kasi Jesu.
See each other. Impartation 7-8 June. You may be seated. 7-8 June. We're going to be together for impartation. Because we are going to Israel. Tell your neighbor, prepare for next year, neighbor. We're going to Israel. And Pastor Nkuna is also going to Israel. Amen. We're going to be walking the streets of Jerusalem together. It's going to be so, so great. So what?
So great.
And when we come back full. You know, the devil is in trouble. It was 40 days. And then the first night prayer and anointing service, powerful, powerful. Then we moved on. seventh year. You'll be in 24 hours celebration. And while the enemy was trying to recover, while he was still trying to recover, then it was Good Friday. And we leveled, moving in power and anointing. And when he tried again to do like this, the previous services, do you know that on the 27th, we had a very powerful wedding. Have you ever heard of a wedding in the presence of God everywhere? God moving in a powerful way. I've never seen that. And anyway, that is what everybody is saying. I've never seen that.
Yeah.
Go ask whoever was there. They are just going to tell you, I've never seen that.
Amen.
That is the language that I've never seen that. Huh? You know, God just did wonders. Before that wedding, I was just feeling that I was getting pumped every day. The anointing was flowing in a powerful way. It only stopped after Friday. And that wedding set a new record of live Facebook live broadcast.
Amen.
Because the blessing part, I checked and I saw that it had reached about 200,000 people, and 100,000 people were watching. I said, oh, wow. Because the highest one that I knew, I mean, in South Africa, really, people don't have data, and it's expensive. So I think the first Tuesday service went to 70-something people who really watched it seriously, not those who were browsing through. And then the wedding came and took it up. And while we were thinking that we were recovering from the wedding, breakthrough night prayer was coming at church. And even that week, the anointing was flowing. And the devil tried to intensify attacks and whatever. But that Friday, I remember, when I stood there at the pulpit, it was like a power was just getting pumped and pumped. And it was a crazy, crazy night prayer. And then from there, we came here. And the next week, we are going to be in Venda. And when we came back, when we come back from Venda, then we are going to be at O.R. Tambo going to Israel. And after Israel, we come back and we go impartation. We have to share. Hey. The Lord is good, eh? The Lord is wonderful. Can you clap to him? It was so, so great being with you. So, so great. It's just that when I come here on Sunday, you will leave late. I try to see you once. The last Sunday I was here, I think it's 2 years ago. I mean on a Sunday. Mm-hmm. So, we're just making up for lost time.